Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. Do you want to learn about Kali Linux and want to try it out before committing to a full installation? You have come to the right place. Today I will show you how to install Kali Linux on VirtualBox in Windows 11. This is the perfect way to explore and test Kali Linux without affecting your main system. So let's get started. Before you begin, here's what you will need for this installation: a Windows 11 PC, Oracle VirtualBox, Kali Linux ISO, minimum 2 GB of RAM, and minimum 20 GB free disk space. So first, we need to download and install Oracle VirtualBox. So first, open your web browser and search for download VirtualBox. And go to the VirtualBox websites. Here you can see the latest VirtualBox version 7.0.18 platform package. From here, download the latest version of Windows host. Okay, just click on this. It's nearly 104 MB size, so download can take few seconds depending on your internet speed. Okay. Once the download is complete, run the installer and you can follow the on-screen instruction to install VirtualBox on your computer. Next, let's download the Kali Linux ISO file, which is the image we will use to install Kali. Okay, so for that, open your web browser and here you need to search for Kali Linux. And in the search result, go to the kali.org official websites. And now you can see it's the most advanced penetration testing distribution. Okay, and here you just click on download and you will get two options over here: installer images and virtual machine. You need to click on installer images. Okay, so then you will get different installer option for 32-bit and 64-bit. For most users, the 64-bit version will be appropriate. Okay, so simply click on the download arrow and your download should start automatically. And you can see it's around 4 GB of size. So this might take a few minutes depending on your internet speed. Okay. Once the download has completed successfully, we can now proceed to the next step of creating the virtual machine. So for that, open your virtual box that you had installed earlier. Okay. After that, once it's open, then click on new button to create a new virtual machine. Here you need to specify a name for this virtual machine. It could be anything. Okay, so I'm going to name it Kali Linux. And this is the path where your Kali Linux will be created. If you want, you can change the location, otherwise keep it like this. In the ISO image field, you need to browse the Kali Linux ISO file that you have downloaded earlier. If everything set, click on next. Here, VirtualBox needs a certain amount of base memory or RAM for your virtual machines. You can adjust this based on your system available memory. Okay, a minimum 2 GB is recommended, but 4 GB or more will provide better performance. And the same way, increase the processor count to a minimum of 2. After that, press next to proceed. In the hard disk menu, choose the create a virtual hard disk now options. Here you need to specify the disk capacity, means you need to specify the amount of hard disk space the virtual machine can use. Okay, so I'm going to make it 50 GB. According to your system specification, you can reduce or increase the space. Okay, then click on next to move to the final summary screen. Here you can review the settings for your virtual machines. After that, click finish to create the VM. Now in the left pane, you will see your Kali Linux should be ready. Before starting the VM and beginning the installation process, we need to make some configuration settings to make it suitable for Kali Linux. Okay. So to do the same, click on settings icon. Select the Advanced tab in the General section and change the Shared Clipboard and Drag and Drop setting to Bidirectional. These features allow the host and the guest machine to exchange files. Okay. After that comes to the Display option. Here you need to set the video memory increase to 128 MB. Then check the Enable 3D Acceleration options. Then select Network from the menu on the left side. And here you need to change the Attach to Field to Bridge Adapter. And finally press OK to save your virtual machine settings. And it will return to your main window. With everything set up, it's time to start the VM and install Kali Linux on that. Okay, so for that, click on the Start button. When the virtual machine starts, you will see the Kali Linux boot menu. And you will get a list of options to install Kali Linux. So here you need to select Graphical Install using the arrow key on the keyboard and press Enter. And select your preferred language. By default it will be English and click Continue. In the next screen, choose your country and then click Continue. Next, select the native keyboard layout using the arrow key. By default it is American English. And this should begin the installation of the operating system. In the next screen, enter a host name for your system, like I assign Kali, and then click Continue. Enter the domain name for your system, I will leave it blank. And in this screen, it will ask for the setup users and password. This is very important. Okay, so without the username and password, you will not be able to log into your Kali Linux machine. So it says type a full name for the new user to create an account. So I'm going to name it Tech Infokart. Then click on Continue. On the next screen, you would need to enter the username for your account. I'm going to name it Tech. Then click on Continue. And here, you need to choose a password for the new user, which you will use to enter into your system post-installation. Okay. So you need to again re-enter password to verify. And finally, click on Continue. Now it's time to partition your disk. You need to just keep this at default. Guided, use entire disk and hit Continue. Again click on Continue. And in the next screen, the installation wizard will ask you to choose a partition scheme. So highlight the option that says all files in one partition, recommended for new user. And after that click on Continue. Select Finish Partition and Word Change to Disk. And click on Continue. Then select Yes for confirming the changes and click on Continue. In the next screen, in case you want to add some additional software, you can select it from the following screen like Gnome, KDE, Plasma. Then click on Continue to proceed. This installation process can take some time, so please be patient. Now install the Grub bootloader. Select Yes and click Continue. Install the Grub bootloader by selecting DBSDA bootloader device. Okay. Then followed by Continue. Now wait for another few minutes to complete the setup. Because it's Kali Linux, the installation might be a bit lengthy. Okay, so grab a cup of coffee, relax and let the installer do its job. Once the installation is complete, you need to click on Continue to reboot the virtual machine. And you will see the Kali Linux login screen. So you need to log in with the user, click on it, and here you need to type the password. And congratulations, you now have Kali Linux running on your Windows 11 machine using VirtualBox. So take some time to explore this new environment. If you want to make this full screen, click on the full screen button under View tab in the toolbar and then click on Switch, and it will expand to cover your entire screen. See? Enjoy your new setup. Now you can start exploring all the powerful tools that Kali has to offer. And that's it. You have got a Kali Linux up and running in VirtualBox on Windows 11 machine. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe for more tutorials, and leave a comment if you run into any issue or have any questions. Okay. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.